Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll be learning how to calculate the consumer surplus and the producer surplus from scratch, step by step, using nothing but the supply and demand equations. With that said, let's get into it. So as promised, we'll be doing this step by step, and so we're starting literally with nothing on our page. The first thing that you should do when trying to calculate consumer and producer surplus is to draw out a general supply and demand graph, starting with the axes. And then of course we'll include a general supply and demand curve, but we don't have values for this just yet. That comes after being given the equations. However, we can still label our generalized graph and it looks something like this. So I've just labeled my P star, Q star, the two axes and my two curves. Now that I've drawn this general supply and demand graph out, I'm now ready for my supply and demand equations to come into play. So let's take a look at them. The supply and demand equations are as follows. The demand equation, quantity demanded, is equal to 270 minus 5p, and the supply equation is quantity supplied is equal to 10p. So now that we have our demand and supply equation, we're going to take note of them, and we're going to use them to calculate four key points on this generalized supply and demand graph. The first point is where the demand curve intersects the price axes. The second point is where the supply curve intersects the price axes. And then we have P star and Q star. Once I've calculated those four points, I'll be able to calculate consumer and producer surplus. Let's begin by calculating equilibrium. So if you aren't sure how to calculate equilibrium, we'll be doing that in this video. However, if you need extra practice, we have other videos on our channel which are dedicated exclusively to calculating equilibrium price and quantity. So please take a look at those if you find yourself needing more practice. However, as this is a step-by-step video, we'll be going over how to do that in this video as well. So when calculating P star and Q star, you simply set the demand equation equal to the supply equation, and that's going to yield us 270 minus 5P is equal to 10P. After some simple rearranging, I get 270 is equal to 15p. And then finally, isolating for p, I get p star, or the p value at equilibrium, is equal to $18. Now that I have p star, I can sub it into the quantity demanded or quantity supplied equation. I'm going to use the supply equation because it's significantly easier. However, no matter which one I sub it into, it's going to give me the same value for q. So subbing it into the supply equation, I get q star, or Q at equilibrium, is equal to 10 times our new price, which is 18. 10 times 18 is 180, and therefore I now have my Q star, which is 180. P star is 18, and Q star is 180. So let me transfer those values onto my graph. Now that they're labeled on my graph, instead of Q star and P star, I actually have their values, I'm looking for two more points. That is where the demand curve intersects the price axes and where the supply curve intersects the price axes. So these are the last two points I need to calculate consumer and producer surplus. So how do I do that again? Well, anywhere along the price axes, we know that the quantity is zero. That is, for a y-intercept, the x value must be zero. So all I need to do for each equation is set quantity equal to zero and solve for p. And that's going to give me my p-intercept, or my y-intercept in this case. Let's start with the demand equation, which will yield us the price-intercept for the demand curve. So subbing in zero for q, I get zero is equal to 270 minus 5p. Rearranging, I get 5p is equal to 270, and then finally, isolating for p, I get a p-value of 54. So that is my p-intercept for the demand curve. Doing the same thing for the supply equation, I get 0 is equal to 10p. Well, this one's even easier. P must be equal to 0 as well. Now that I have my p-intercepts for the supply and demand curves, I can now label those on the graph as well. So now that everything's labeled, we're on to our final step, and that is actually using these four points to calculate consumer surplus and producer surplus. As for the supply and demand equations, well, now that we've used them to calculate these four values, we no longer need them anymore, so let's get rid of them. Now remember, consumer surplus is the area below the demand curve and above the market price, and producer surplus is the area above the supply curve and below the market price. So all I need to do is calculate the area of these two triangles. So let me center out this graph in the middle and we'll start solving. The area of a triangle is simply equal to base times height divided by 2. We'll start by calculating consumer surplus, or the green triangle. Here, the base is 180 and the height is 36. The height in this case is simply the difference between 54 and 18, which is 36. So if the area of the triangle is base times height divided by 2, then consumer surplus must be 180 times 36 divided by 2. And this yields us a result of $3,240. Now we're going to do the exact same thing except for the pink triangle. And you'll notice that now the base is still 180, but the height is 18. And that's simply the difference between 18 and 0. So if the area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2, then producer surplus must be 180 times 18 divided by 2, and this yields me a result of 1,620. And just like that, I've calculated both my consumer surplus and my producer surplus using absolutely nothing but the supply and demand equations. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment down below what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.